how to tweet. So there's some things you should keep in mind when you're composing your tweets. You're only allowed 140 characters per tweet. Keep in mind, these characters also include spaces, commas, periods, and symbols, so it's not just your letters and your words that count. Now we're going to look at a bad example. Since you're only allowed 140 characters, this tweet actually ran off the edge. There was too many characters, we didn't get our entire message out, so your users are going to read this and not know what else you wanted to say, and they have no way of knowing what the rest of the tweet said. You can use symbols such as the ampersand for and, things like that, to shorten any tweets, but be mindful how this may change the tone or meaning of your message. You still want your original meaning and intent to come across. And one way to not shorten your tweet is to use text speak. Definitely try and avoid text speak if you want to be viewed professionally. And just a few examples of text speak are LOL for laugh out loud if you think something is funny, the letter U for you, etc. There's many shortcuts that are used now in text speak. Try to avoid all of these if you want to be viewed professionally. One way you can shorten your tweets, if you're including a link, there are many services out there that shorten web addresses or URLs, such as tinyurl.com, bit.ly.com. There's many of them out there. You can just do a quick web search and find any more of these. Here's a quick example of how bit.ly shortens their website, their web addresses. So you just go to bit.ly.com, and at the bottom of the page, there's a box. They say, just want to shorten a link. Just enter your long link into there. Click the shorten button, and they'll give you back a link that's even highlighted for you just to copy and paste into your tweet. Now we're going to go through an example of how actually to compose a tweet on your Twitter page. So you'll see on your Twitter page, you've got your Twitter column on the right, includes all your tweets. When you're on your home page, this is actually who you're following, and then some information about yourself up at the top left, your tweets, who you're following, who your followers are, your trending topics down below that, etc. But here, directly below your number of tweets, number of people you're following, is this Compose New Tweet box. That's actually where we're going to click in there, and then compose our tweet. So now our tweet is composed. Maybe we want to add a photo to this. Since it's the conference, I took a picture of the conference, so I'm going to add a photo. So you can see right below that box, you've got two buttons, add an image or add your location. We're going to go ahead and add an image. Just click on that and then navigate to your photo and click open. And you see it's going to attach to there. And then maybe you also want to add a link to the conference webpage so that if people want to learn a little bit more about it, they can go ahead and click on the link. So we're going to go over to the ACE conference webpage. You can see their URL. It's not super long, but we want to make it a little bit shorter, make sure it all fits in there. So we're going to copy it and then go to bit.ly.com and paste it into the just want to shorten a link box and then click shorten. And then it's going to go ahead and give us the shortened link. Copy that and then paste it into our box. And see, it's much shorter and we still have 15 characters to spare. Then we go ahead and click tweet, and our tweet's been sent. So you can see it shows up right here, the top of your Twitter stream. You can also go to your profile page and see it there as well. We can expand this to view the photo, and there it is. And then your shortened URL, if we click on that, it'll take you over to the conference webpage, just like we wanted.